Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube channel. Today we are going to solve a couple of numerical problems on three-phase AC circuits. By solving these problems, we shall learn how to compute phase currents, line currents, power factor, active power, reactive power, and apparent power for three-phase balanced delta-connected loads. For balanced three-phase load, total apparent power S equals to 3 times V phase into I phase, where V phase is the phase voltage and I phase is the phase current. Total active power P equals to 3 times V phase into I phase cos phi, where cos phi is the load power factor. P may be expressed as S into cos phi. Total reactive power Q equals to 3 times V phase into I phase sin phi. That is equal to S into sin phi. For balanced 3-phase delta connected load, line voltage VL equals to phase voltage V phase, and line current IL equals to root 3 times I phase, where I phase is the phase current. Now we can write apparent power S equals to root 3 times VL into IL. Active power P equals to root 3 times VL into IL cos phi. And reactive power Q equals to root 3 times VL into IL sin phi. Three identical coils connected in closed delta are fed from a 400 volt 3-phase supply. The load takes a total power of 50 kilowatt at a line current of 90 ampere. We have to determine the phase current, the power factor, and the total apparent power. Let us first write down the given data. Power intake Pin equals to 50 kilowatts. Line to line terminal voltage VL equals to 400 volts. Since the coils are connected in delta, VL equals to phase voltage V phase. Line current IL equals to 90 ampere. For balanced delta connected load, phase current I phase equals to IL by root 3, that is equal to 90 divided by root 3, that gives us 51.9615 ampere. For balanced 3-phase load, total apparent power S equals to root 3 times VL into IL. Using values we get root 3 into 400 into 90. That gives us 62,354 volt ampere or 62.354 kilovolt ampere. Or total apparent power S equals to 3 times V phase into I phase. Using values we get 3 into 400 into 51.9615. That gives us 62,354 volt amperes or 62.354 kilovolt ampere. Expression for power intake Pin equals to S into cos phi. Therefore, power factor cos phi equals to Pin divided by S. Using values we get 50 divided by 62.354. That gives us 0.80187 lagging. Three coils, each of 5 ohm resistance and 6 ohm inductive reactance, are connected in closed delta and supplied from a 440 volt 3-phase system. we have to calculate the line and phase currents, the power factor of the system, and the intake in watts. Let us first write down the given data. Line-to-line terminal voltage VL equals to 440 volts. Since the load is delta connected, VL equals to phase voltage V phase. Resistance per phase R equals to 5 ohm. Inductive reactance per phase XL equals to 6 ohm. Let us now write down impedance per phase. Z equals to R plus JXL, that is equal to 5 plus J 6 ohm. This may be written in polar form as 7.81 ohm at an angle 50.2 degree. We shall now calculate phase current. I phase equals to V phase divided by Z. Using values we get 440 divided by 7.81, that is equal to 56.338 ampere. For delta connected load, line current IL equals to root 3 times I phase, that is equal to root 3 into 56.338, that gives us 97.58 ampere. Power factor of the system, cos phi equals to cos of 50.2 degree, that is equal to 0.64 lagging. Now we shall determine total power intake. P equals to root 3 times VL into IL cos phi. Using values we get root 3 into 440 into 97.58 into 0.64, that gives us 47,594.2 watts. The load in each branch of a delta connected balanced three-phase circuit comprises of an inductance of 0.0318 Henry in series with a resistance of 10 ohm. The line voltage is 400 volts at 50 hertz. We have to compute the line current and the total power in the circuit. Let us first write down the given data. Line to line terminal voltage VL equals to 400 volts. Since the load is delta connected, VL equals to phase voltage V phase. Supply frequency F equals to 50 Hz. Resistance per phase R equals to 10 ohm. Inductance per phase L equals to 0.0318 Henry. Let us now calculate inductive reactance per phase. XL equals to 2 pi F into L. Using values we get 2 pi into 50 into 0.0318, that is equal to 10 ohm. Now we shall write down impedance per phase in phasor form. Z equals to R plus JXL, that is equal to 10 plus J10 ohm. This may be written in polar form as 14.1421 ohm at an angle 45 degree. Phase current I phase equals to V phase divided by Z. Using values we get 400 divided by 14.1421, that is equal to 28.2843 ampere. For delta connected load, line current IL equals to root 3 times I phase, that is equal to root 3 into 28.2843, that gives us 49 ampere. Now we shall determine power factor of the load. cos phi equals to cos of 45 degree, that is equal to 0.7071 lagging. Now we shall determine total power absorbed in the circuit. P equals to root 3 times VL into IL cos phi. Using values we get root 3 into 400 into 49 into 0.7071. That gives us 24,000 watts or 24 kilowatts. A star connected alternator supplies a delta connected load. The impedance of the load branch is 8 plus j 6 ohm per phase. The line voltage is 230 volts. We have to determine current in the load branch, power consumed by the load, power factor of the load, and reactive power of the load. Let us first write down the given data. Line to line terminal voltage VL equals to 230 volts. Since the load is delta connected, VL equals to phase voltage V phase. Impedance per phase Z equals to 8 plus J6 ohm. This may be written in polar form as 10 ohm at an angle 36.8699 degree. Let us now calculate phase current. I phase equals to V phase divided by Z. Using values we get 230 divided by 10. That gives us 23 ampere. Power factor of the load cos phi equals to cos of 36.8699 degree, that is equal to 0.8 lagging. Sin phi equals to sin of 36.8699 degree, that is equal to 0.6. Now we shall calculate apparent power. S equals to 3 times V phase into I phase. Using values we get 3 into 230 into 23. That gives us 15,870 volt ampere. Power consumed by the load P equals to S into cos phi. Using values we get 15,870 into 0.8. That gives us 12,696 watts. Reactive power of the load QL equals to S into sin phi. Using values we get 15,870 into 0.6. That gives us 9,522 volt ampere reactive. Each phase of a delta connected load comprises of a resistor of 50 ohm and a capacitor of 50 microfarad in series. We have to calculate the line and phase currents, the total power, and the kilovolt amperes when the load is connected to a 440 volt 3 phase 50 hertz supply. Let us now write down the given data. Line to line terminal voltage VL equals to 440 volts. Since the load is delta connected, VL equals to phase voltage V phase. Supply frequency F equals to 50 hertz. Resistance per phase R equals to 50 ohm. Capacitance per phase C equals to 50 microfarads. That is equal to 50 into 10 to the power minus 6 farad. Now we shall determine capacitive reactance per phase. XC equals to 1 upon 2 pi F into C. Using values we get 1 upon 2 pi into 50 into 50 into 10 to the power minus 6. That is equal to 63.662 ohm. Now we shall write down impedance per phase in phasor form. Z equals to R minus JXC. That is equal to 50 minus J, 63.662 ohm. This may be written in polar form as 80.9497 ohm at an angle minus 51.854 degree. Let us now calculate phase current. I phase equals to V phase divided by Z. Using values we get 440 divided by 80.9497. That is equal to 5.4355 ampere. For delta connected load, line current IL equals to root 3 times I phase. That is equal to root 3 into 5.4355. That gives us 9.4146 ampere. Power factor of the load, cos phi equals to cos of 51.854 degree. That is equal to 0.6177 leading. For 3-phase load, apparent power, S equals to 3 times V phase into I phase. Using values we get 3 into 440 into 5.4355. That gives us 7174.86 volt ampere or 7.17486 kilovolt ampere. Total power absorbed in the circuit, P equals to S into cos phi. Using values we get 7174.86 into 0.6177. That gives us 4431.911 watts. Each phase of a delta connected load has a resistance of 25 ohm, an inductance of 0.15 henry and a capacitance of 120 microfarad. The load is connected across a 400 volt 50 hertz 3-phase power supply. We have to calculate the line current, active power, reactive power and volt amperes. Let us first write down the given data. Line to line terminal voltage VL equals to 400 volts. Since the load is delta connected, VL equals to phase voltage V phase. Supply frequency F equals to 50 Hz. Resistance per phase R equals to 25 ohm. Inductance per phase L equals to 0.15 henry. Capacitance per phase C equals to 120 microfarad. That is equal to 120 into 10 to the power minus 6 farad. Let us now calculate inductive reactance per phase. XL equals to 2 pi F into L. Using values we get 2 pi into 50 into 0.15. That gives us 47.1239 ohm. Capacitive reactance per phase XC equals to 1 upon 2 pi F into C. Using values we get 1 upon 2 pi into 50 into 120 into 10 to the power minus 6. That gives us 26.5258 ohm. Now we shall write down impedance per phase in phasor form. Z equals to R plus JXL minus XC. Using values we get 25 plus J, 20.5981 ohm. This may be written in polar form as 32.3926 ohm at an angle 39.4859 degree. Now we shall determine phase current. I phase equals to V phase divided by Z. Using values we get 400 divided by 32.3926, that is equal to 12.3485 ampere. For delta connected load, line current IL equals to root 3 times I phase, that is equal to root 3 into 12.3485. That gives us 21.3882 ampere. For 3 phase load, apparent power S equals to root 3 times VL into IL. Using values we get root 3 into 400 into 21.3882. That gives us 14,818 volt ampere. From power triangle we get active power P equals to S into cos phi. Using values we get 14,818 into cos of 39.4859 degree, that is equal to 11,436 watts. And reactive power QL equals to S into sin phi. Using values we get 14,818 into sin of 39.4859 degree. That is equal to 9,422.6 volt ampere reactive. So today we have solved a couple of numerical problems on three-phase AC circuits. By solving these problems, so we have learned how to compute phase currents, line currents, power factor, active power, reactive power, and apparent power for three-phase balanced delta-connected loads. Hope this lecture has been useful for you. If you have any suggestion or question, please drop it in the comment section below. If you have liked this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thank you.